But it also doesn't mean like just be gritting up, right? We're not trying to win here. We're trying to learn and improve, okay? So just, you know, be a great partner as far as finding that middle level of resistance so he gets the correct feel. Now, once we close the gap, all right, let's build on that. We're going to put some forward pressure. And I really want you guys to develop a feel for wrestling, not just do moves, okay? That's all about, like, winning the hand fight is for the purpose of being able to attack his stance, give yourself an opportunity to maximize your offense while you limit his, right? That's all part of winning the hand fight and feeling wrestling, right? So now I'm going to take advantage of, once I close the gap on Joe and I put some forward pressure, I'm stalking him in until I can feel that foot brace a little bit, and that's your cue. When you feel that resistance, it'll be kind of against your forearm, is when you pull down and circle your feet, right? So you're into your stance, checking your height each time, closing the gap, right? Backhand reaches, low to high, inside to out. I'm stalking Joey here, and I feel that. See his left foot is planted? Now my lead hand is going to come up to the back of his neck. I'm going to pull and circle, okay, Joe? All right, I'm going to pull down and circle Joey and attack his stance here, all right? Does he look like he can be in a very good offensive position right now? No, all right? Now, the whole deal is we're going to be building kind of layers to this, but depending on how he responds to the hand fight, you might find yourself getting some opportunities to fire off an attack, right? It depends how he responds. Again, I want you to feel wrestling. So closing that gap, putting the pressure on Joey, I feel a brace, pull down, circle your feet. If he responds up, now I'm in position where I'm in my level change to pop a shot off, right? Double high crotch, you know, sweep a single or whatever, right? So if you feel that as you're going out drilling, go ahead and level change and pop a shot off, okay? If it's there, we're pressuring, stalk and pull down, circle your feet. All right, if he recovers up, circle Joey. Good, it's not there. Stalk him, pull down, circle your feet. Stalk him, pull down, circle your feet. If he pops, get your offense going, you take it, right? It's about feel, not just shooting at random because you want to shoot. You're pressuring him, destroying his position, and as he responds back up, you take advantage of an opening that you created, right? And if it's not there, as he recovers up, stalk him forward, feel him brace, pull down, circle your feet again. See if you create another opening. That make sense to you guys? All right, so take the time. Let's drill for learning here. Working to improve. One, two, three.